Donny Mafia. What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome to yet another edition of the Don Mafia Report. I am certainly hoping that you are enjoying what seems like day 39 of this quarantine for the virus, which shall not be named according to YouTube monetization principles. I'm going absolutely insane. I'm not going to lie to you. Now, normally I'm a homebody, but for some reason, when somebody tells me not to do something, I want to do something more often. So me going out and being social, well, back in the day, it really didn't seem like it was much of a necessity for Jaboy. Now I'm just dying to go to a place where I can just have a beer, sit at a bar, and talk to a bunch of random people I've never met or so I've ever had a need to start a conversation with. But you know what, guys? I hope that we all get through this. I know we will all get through this because we're the Don Mafia, baby. You read the title correctly, that is for sure. We're going to be diving in today. What do the Buffalo Bills really need? I've said this in past videos where I've said, before this free agency period even started, there was cemented needs out there. We needed a receiver, we needed an edge rusher, we needed some depth here and there, linebacker, cornerback, but surprisingly, we have seen that Brandon Bean has really addressed all of our core needs in free agency by itself. So now we realize that, yes, there's still some potential free agent moves that we can make. And then, of course, we have the NFL draft coming up. So now that raises the question, what exactly do the Buffalo Bills still need? Do we need anything? Or do we just need to make upgrades in positions and grab the best player available when it comes to draft time? That's something that I thought that we should all explore together in today's video. And so before we get into that, guys, I do want to highlight a couple of things. Many of you have actually asked me, Dan, how can I support your channel? Well, first and foremost, it's just by showing up and watching my videos, liking them, and then telling your friends to watch them. That's the number one way to do so. But then number two is Patreon. For those of you who don't know, I do have a Patreon page where I have different levels of membership, sort of like premium content, right? Specifically, we have a tier for $1. I really can't give you anything for a dollar, but say that you want to donate. I love you, dude. $3 is where it gets interesting. I give you a shout out on my next video that I publish on YouTube. And then you also get access to my Discord channel, which is essentially a giant chat room of people that gather together to talk about a specific topic, in our case, the Buffalo Bills and the NFL. You get full access to that. The $5 tier, with that, you actually not only get the exact same thing that the first two tiers get, but you also get exclusive rights, exclusive sneak peeks to my Patreon-only videos. These videos can be whatever you want me to make them about. It could be a look back into Bills history or something specific. You'll only be able to see these videos on my Patreon and are only for contributors by itself. And then the $10 contributors, your name will live in infamy in my end credits, which is basically internet immortality, baby. And plus you get everything else that the lower tiers get. So say that you want to support the channel, then by all means do it. If not, I totally understand. And just keep coming and watching my vids, baby. So, ladies and gentlemen, like I said, the title of this video is what exactly do the Buffalo Bills still need, right? So, like I said, we basically addressed everything that we really needed during free agency. Wide receiver, obviously, we made that blockbuster trade for Stephon Diggs. We still have Beasley on the roster. We still have John Brown on the roster. We ended up signing Robert Foster, which was very random. I didn't expect that. And then today, as a matter of fact, we ended up re-signing Isaiah McKenzie too, which is sort of our jet route, sort of our jet sweep weapon, which is absolutely awesome. And then, of course, we still have Duke Williams on the roster. So it seems like our receiver room is wildly filled. Maybe we'll pick up like a Chase Claypool, cut Foster. Who knows what's going to go on there. And then after that, we ended up addressing edge rusher with Mario Addison, who I think is going to be an absolute stud in 2020, but that's a conversation for a different day. So now really it comes down to what exactly do the Buffalo Bills really need? And in my opinion, I think that there are two main positions that need to be addressed throughout the remainder of the offseason, if you will. Number one is running back. That's right. Devin Singletary, ladies and gentlemen, cannot do it by himself. Now, several of us have had an exhaustive wish list of the different running backs that could come in and could complement Devin Singletary for the 2020 season. I heard a lot of conversation about Todd Gurley, about Melvin Gordon, but we all understand that they ended up going elsewhere during free agency itself. And I personally was super excited about Jordan Howard during the offseason, but then ultimately he ended up signing for the Miami Dolphins. So now there's really only a couple of options out there. So as far as addressing the running back situation, I would love to pick up like a Devontae Freeman off of free agency, which I think would be absolutely amazing. Maybe like a Carlos Hyde, a Lamar Miller. I think that we could really go on ahead and address that secondary running back to come on in. Now, we can potentially turn to the draft and try to find a running back at that point, but any like absolute stud who is going to show up is most likely going to be taken within either the first round or the very beginning of the second round. So our best option in the draft would be the gentleman from LSU. Forgive me, I don't have his name on the top of my mind at this moment, but he would probably be really the only realistic option that we can get, that or J.K. Dobbins. But as far as Brandon Bean is concerned, I think that while Devin Singletary is still very young, I think that he wants to fill that void that Frank Gore took over from 2019 and bring that leadership in there, sort of mentorship. So don't be surprised if Brandon Bean ends up turning to a running back like Carlos Hyde or maybe a Lamar Miller to bring in and then sort of complement Singletary as well, which in ultimately will also give a lot more production, because while Frank Gore was absolutely amazing in 2019, you could tell that his age was starting to catch up to him for sure. So running back was definitely the first thing that needed to be addressed. And then number two is definitely going to have to be cornerback, right? So we all know that we ended up signing Josh Norman. Many of us called it the second that he was released from the Washington Redskins. Number one, because, you know, I mean, we are the Carolina Panthers of the North. Besides that, it was a great depth move. But the problem with Josh Norman is the fact that he is a zone cornerback, and so is Levi Wallace. Both of them are zone cornerbacks. And the one cornerback we had last year, which is Kevin Johnson, he was the one cornerback that absolutely thrived in man-to-man coverage. And now we really don't have that weapon, say that we ever need to go into man coverage in 2020. So I think that Brandon Bean might actually be focusing that second pick in the draft next month on finding a cornerback, somebody that can really thrive in man coverage, or whether or not that he wants to turn to free agency. I'm not sure if there's any big names still available at this point, or maybe there's some type of value picks out there, but I do foresee that still going down. And so I think that those are the only two needs that the Buffalo Bills need to fulfill at this point. Many of you, I know, are probably going to say that we still need an edge rusher. I mean, I really like Trent Murphy. I like Mario Addison. I think those two will suffice. In the worst case scenario, we will just focus on the 2021 draft in the offseason next year to grab a young stud. I'm not seeing a Yannick Ngakoue deal going through anytime soon. So in my opinion, I think that a more desperate need is going to be a cornerback and a secondary running back for the Buffalo Bills. And we're probably going to sleep on our edge rusher at this point, since we have seemed to already fill that necessity with a bunch of value picks so far. So that's going to have to be the video, ladies and gentlemen. Just a quick reminder, I am doing that ticket giveaway. I have had several entries already. You already know the rules. What you need to do is take a screenshot of you being subscribed to my YouTube channel, DM me on Twitter at RealDanMitchell with the proof of the screenshot of you being subscribed, and you are entered into the competition of my giveaway for two tickets to the home opener of the Buffalo Bills. So make sure you enter that. Besides that, say that you're new here. My name is Dan Mitchell, and I regularly put out Buffalo Bills and NFL videos on a consistent basis. If that's your cup of tea, subscribe to the channel, like this video, make sure you tell a friend, and that's about it. Don Mafia, Love ya. Stay healthy. And above all else, let's go Buffalo.